Today we're gonna cook sugarcane lacquered quail. This is an approximation of a dish that I had at Commander's Palace, famous restaurant in New Orleans a few weeks ago. I took one bite of that quail and said, I've gotta try this in the kitchen at home. We're gonna use a technique called sous vide. Now we're not gonna go into a lot of detail this week. We're gonna talk more about it on a future episode, but it's a great way to cook wild game that tends to get dried out with conventional cooking methods. Sous vide is literally French for under vacuum. We've sealed with our food saver bags, the birds and individual bags like this. You can also use conventional zip seal bags and remove as much air as possible. But what we've got here is a water immersion heater circulator that's the cooking method. And this pumps warm water, recirculates through here, and it keeps it at a precise temperature. In this case, 140 degrees. And we put some Cajun seasoning and on the birds, stuff them with a little boudin sausage, got them sealed up there. We're gonna cook these for about 2 hours and they will not dry out with this cooking method. We're gonna finish it on the grill later, but this is a great thing to do with all sorts of game. This water circulator immersion cooking device, commonly referred to as a precision cooker, has Bluetooth, so I can sync it with my phone, set it for 2 hours, set the timer, and we're good to go. And it'll let me know as soon as it's ready to take it out. While our quail are cooking in the water bath, we're gonna do a couple of things. We're gonna make our glaze, our sugarcane glaze, as well as a little sweet and spicy dipping sauce. And we're also going to braise some cabbage that we're gonna use when we plate the quail. We're gonna start our glaze by browning the wings and necks that we cut off the quail when we prepared it. We're not actually gonna use those pieces. That's really just gonna provide a flavor base for this. And then we're going to add a quarter cup of this rum. Deglaze the pan with your rum, and really you wanna let that rum cook down. We're not looking for the alcohol, we just want the essence. After the rum cooks down a little bit, we're gonna add a half a cup of the sugarcane syrup, and then a half a cup of our molasses, and finally a half a cup of the coffee. We're gonna get that all blended and hot, and we're gonna let that reduce by about half. One of the finishing touches on this dish is gonna be a little spicy and sweet dipping sauce, and we're gonna start with about a cup of Crystal Louisiana style hot sauce. To that, we're going to add 2 teaspoons of apple cider vinegar and then 1 tablespoon of regular granulated sugar. We're gonna dissolve all that, let it cook over a low to medium heat until it also starts to reduce, becomes almost like a little syrup. We're gonna serve the quail atop this braised cabbage. We've just julienned some cabbage as well as some red onion, cooked a couple of strips of bacon to render out the fat, took the bacon out. I sprinkled it with a little bit of white wine vinegar as well as some salt and pepper. And we're gonna cook it until it gets nice and caramelized. Those juices start to cook out, and that'll be a nice little bed for us to place our quail on top of when we finish this dish. We've moved outside to the PK grill. When you cook sous vide, you do have to brown the meat to finish it, either in a skillet, on the stovetop, under the broiler, or in this case, on the grill. We're gonna put some nice marks on it and also caramelize that sugarcane glaze on the outside of these quail. We're gonna get into that nice glaze there. Just paint that right on. Ooh, what you talking about? You see why they call it lacquered, sugarcane lacquered, because it really does look a lot like like you're working on wood here. Doesn't take much at all. Get your nice marks on there. Paint this side. Do a little bit of our sauce. And there you have it. Sugarcane glazed quail with braised cabbage.